Hey everybody, it's Risley. Today we're playing Super Auto Pets on the weekly. Let's give it a go. Alrighty, cursing me with all the worst units plus a duck. Well, in that case, completely redeemed yourself. Both of you can get out of my face. A pied tamarin. Question, he requires trumpets. Additional question, does anybody give us trumpets? The answer appears to be literally no, so you can get out of everybody's face and force me to run this garbage. You know what? I probably should have just bought an apple. Honestly, in terms of long run, the frilled dragon is doing nothing. It's a 1-1. An innocent millionaire. Oh, we're being the impossible today. The frilled is a 1-1. It's literally like I bought a bee that's gonna last up until I sell it, and it is going to get sold, mind you that, so absolutely kind of a waste of space. Would putting a 1-1 apple on one of these two units have helped us there? Who's to say? But you're out, because I will not live in a world in which this otter stats go to that kind of man. That's not too bad, and you're out again. Should I have kept it? Well, when you say it that way, I would probably say yes. Instead, we're gonna go 4-squatted. If I had kept that otter, I would have had a level 3 otter. And by 3, I mean 2, if I cram myself to sleep. Pretty sure last game I was running golden poop, and now I'm running regular stinky poop. No fun. I mean, it's better than golden poop. Ooh, another otter. Wow, they really said, got you. I got you, fam. Alright, you're getting there. You're getting there. We will level next turn, so this turn we will look for one temporary unit, which that is a very good temporary unit. Definitely checks all the boxes in terms of what I was looking for. Especially since I have a future of pills. There are pills in the future. Okay, well, I see that they're setting up for something. They don't have it yet, but they're surely setting up for it. They've got a horse in case they want to go summons. They've got an elephant in case they want to go, what, blowfish? Is blowfish the only thing that's really going on with summons right now? Basically, yeah. It can be hard to run an animal when it feels like its only purpose is to go with, like, a specific other animal, you know? I guess duck can go. Sort of like how the koala... People only use the koala in combination with a yak. That's like the entire purpose of its being, is to be used next to a yak. Such that I don't even like the yak all that much. It's like a bit of scaling, but I never want to get the koala just because I'm like, in no other instance are you strong or good at anything. You're kind of just like a decorative pretty item to go next to the yak, which somebody may or may not actually enjoy. We beat up a goose wearing a nurse hat. Makes me feel a little bad. I mean, our medical professionals, such the disrespect that we gotta show them, but sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Get some stats. Ooh, level 2 you, which would not kill anybody because no one is back there, or instantly level 2. We're gonna go with this, if only to save money, but I will save the hedgehog just to level for the next tier unit. I don't really want to keep the hedgehog. I am definitely a believer that it's a very temporary unit and isn't the greatest. While I can see how you might have like a team of like, what, like 4 blowfish and a hedgehog or something, I really don't think that kind of stuff plays out very often, so I'm not one to run it. If I put a bee on this guy, we would have won like 3 turns by now. Really goes to show the virtue of a bee. Okay, so you're leveled. It would have been really cool if you would give me something that I wanted so that I don't feel like I'm wasting stats by killing this in front of all of these garbage units. At least we're getting a little bit of melon armor out of it. Is that worth it? Oh, you know what? I probably should have loved that first. Push the last unit to the front. Well, I hate you, but once again, we don't really have a whole lot going for us otherwise, so... I mean, the stats aren't bad. Wow, this team is entirely brown. And I put the melon in the middle. Oh, accidentally a graphic designer. You shouldn't have. A goose with a Robin Hood hat on. Something about that feels oddly correct. Nope, nope, nope. Hey, joke's on you, level 2. Joke's on you, I'm level 2. I recently got back from the grocery store. There was a worker there who was getting all the carts together. And they started flowing down the street because he went inside for a hot second. Someone else like grabbed them and was pushing them back up. And he came back out and the person was like, hey, I fixed your carts. They were flying away. And the guy was like, thank you, very quietly. He kept working. He's like a teenager, so obviously he's not like the most sociable of persons. And as this, like, helper was walking away, they were like, geez, you should have said thank you. It's just crazy, because I'm like, on one hand, like, I could see if you hadn't heard him say thank you, which you did, how you could be upset, but also, the kind of person who I feel like not only has the thought, geez, you could have said thank you, but also, like, actively vocalizes it, that's crazy. that takes a whole other level of kahunas, my dude. You actually, like, vocalized it? That's kind of rude. Whether or not you were owed a thank you, it's kind of rude for you to make it verbalized that you really wanted one. Like, what were you fixing the carts because you were, like, so thankful that some teenager was gonna come out and, like, bow? Ooh, double hedgehog. Hey, you're the guy I was just talking about. What was your potato doing there? The potato stopped him from taking damage? We won that so quickly, I didn't even look. Is that what the potato does? What are you? Take 10 less damage from abilities twice. I will admit, I had never considered the concept of doing that. In front? Like, in order to avoid your own damage? Oh, I gotta say though, beta fish plus ox is kind of going off. Can I have another pill? One more for the table? Thank you. Joke's on you, I said one more for the table. I actually meant one more for me and me alone. We're gonna get 10 pizzas, and you're like, oh, why are you getting 10 pizzas? That seems like a lot for one person to eat. And I'm like, oh, silly you, obviously I'm not eating 10 pizzas. I've got an entire party here. And he's like, all right, how many do you want? And I'm like, 10, I just said that. Secretly, it's all mine. Hello, hello. Almost leveling you, almost leveling you. Do I actually want any of these things I'm almost done leveling? Not really. It seems like a waste to put him directly behind the turtle, though, because obviously the turtle's, like, already giving melon armor. Double turtle plus brown. Brown plus green. Blue plus brown. Oh, it's all coming together. Okay, who could win? A 2-5 turtle versus a 2-3 beta fish. Oh, on a hippo? No! I was almost strong enough. Oh, I am. I was gonna say I was almost strong enough to beat that, and I still was. In fact, I'm even gonna get 2 pills off of this one. Alright, throw a little bit of respect on the ox. He did his job. He did his job, plus a little bit more. I feel like I'm eating my own words here. I've been so against the ox up until this very point. Oh, you know what? I haven't tried this guy yet. Start of battle, summon 1 12-tum orangutan with the same food perk. So, like, he's cool. Wait, 12-tum orangutan? Didn't this guy used to summon a gorilla? What does an orangutan do? Is he in the pack right now? Him? Well, that's useless. He doesn't even do anything in battle. Okay. The reason I bought this was because I remember some, like, I've seen him be used and it'd be cool, but at that point he was summoning a gorilla. So you know what? Get out of here. We're running regular monkey. And who are you gonna buff? I guess the turtle? Whatever. A fire ant. Give attack to 1 random friend. This is actually pretty rad, such that I would like you to get that. And this is a waste of a turtle. So I'm gonna scoot you back again. That's really far back for our main unit. Maybe like this? We got some weirdness going on right here. I mean, I'm trying to be inventive. We're trying to be new here. I've not really run an ox this long before. I think I've only run this fire ant like twice because I don't see it very often. A macaw and an orangutan. Okay, well his orangutan didn't do very much. If I win this round. No! Aw, oh, come on now. If that honeybee hadn't broke my melon armor, I would have actually, like, won, or drew, maybe won. Could have been amazing. Instead, it was lame. Sucks. Alright. Nope, I wanted you to hit the ant. You didn't. That's very rude. Look at all these food items, though. Is that the one that I want to level? I guess. I'm gonna level you. You're gonna get out soon. I don't really care for any of these level-ups, though. I think if we're good with our squad, obviously it'd be best if the fire ant actually got better, but in terms of switching our units out, unless we get like so far that the monkey becomes obsolete, where we're like, you know what, we've got 1 health and a dream, let's kick this monkey out, I think we're good with the squad. That was not the unit I was gonna request you give that attack to. Oh, peanuts and a melon? What is this? Plus you kill? No, whale? You, me, whale, hat, lava? Damn it. Everything did not come together. And at this point, you might as well be here, although that is stinky. You could also say replace him with that, but then what about him? You forgot about him, my dear friend. Or keep the chili. 15 health when hurt once. What are the chances that this fire ant gets hit and doesn't die? I feel like they're not high, so I think I'm gonna go with chili for this turn. And I have no one else, really, that deserves a pita. Everyone else has kind of got like an average grade. You're all in B's, maybe a high C. No one deserves a pita. We're skipping lunch break today. His one kid did something rude. Gerald keeps eating pencils, so none of you guys get food today. Classic punishment system. Ooh, I wasn't even to kill dragonflies? Dragonflies? Come on, my dude. In a world that could have been better. Okay. Level 2. An octopi? 6 damage to all? That's not that bad. It'd be cool if we had pineapples, but we don't, so that's nothing. And I don't want any of you guys. More monkeys, you're gonna make me keep all this crap? Here's another idea. This would allow us to permanently replace him. I'm gonna save that just for one turn. If next term they give me something that is so amazing that I can't refuse it, I might consider pilling this ant. Although it would be super sad because look how much health he has. No, my melon! God! I know what a raccoon can do. I've seen a raccoon do amazing things. Every time I run one, I feel like it dies so early because it sucks in the early game. But it's so gosh darn annoying in the late game. Okay, so anyone I would replace it with? A snake, I guess? In which case I could do this, and then him, and then a snake. And what are you giving? The 2 random friends. 2 random friends get 16 attack? That's probably worth it, right? And then this? And then a bee. Alright. This was, by all means, a very large pivot. It's very interesting to have, like, a level 5 pet, a tier 5 pet, that is actually worth it to pill, even after it gets all those stats. And I feel like this puppy even was better than investing those stats into some random other guy like this ox. Which I wasn't doing, mostly just because obviously I didn't want to get rid of his opportunity to make another melon in case he lost his before the game start, but still. Aw, dragonfly. Aw, death. Come on, this was going somewhere. This was going somewhere. I felt it in my bones. My bones were getting real jingly about how far that was going somewhere. Let us do one more, and we'll see if we can't get out of here. You get out of here. Goose is fine. I hate you both. I hate you both still. Stop showing up. Who is more likely to stay? Probably a moth. A 3-2 and a 2-2. Isn't this just the stinkiest team? We can be a dense soup. I'm not one for soup myself. But if you had to have a soup, would you like it to be dense? I guess you'd want it to be full of bits. I mean, to be fair though, the more bits that a soup is full of, the less it really is soup, right? At a certain point, it just becomes a chowder. A certain point after that, it becomes a casserole. It's kind of like Pokemon Evolution, if you think about it really hard. And you really shouldn't, because that actually makes no gosh darn sense. It's kind of like Pokemon Evolution, if you don't think about it at all. People should say that more. Alright, double goose, otter, duck, moth. Now that we're all acquainted, here's the enemy. I think that you might be kind of familiar with what the enemy is made of, because it's extremely similar to what I am made of, except they're wearing a nurse hat. Which means that if they die, they can patch themselves back up. How interesting would it be? This would be like a whole other dynamic to the game that would be incredibly hard to balance, and also, as a result of that fact, I think they would never do it. But, you see how they got these hats. What if they added something like a hat? That gave you, like, an ability that was kind of more major, you know? Like a pendant or something. You can have, like, the pendant of healing, where you get +1 health and then it breaks. So you, like, gain a life, basically. You can have a pendant of more damage, where, like, every third turn, everyone gets, like, +2 attack or something, you know? Like, an external force that you can equip. And so it becomes not only, like, mathing out your team, but also mathing out your equipped. I don't know how you'd, like, choose one, though. I guess maybe at the beginning of each shop, it would have, like, just a selection. It's like, choose one of these two things, or, like, on a certain turn, it would do it. Could be pretty cool. I don't know, game developers. Are you listening? Some hot stuff is being dropped right now. We have a lot of stats to be given out. Do I want to give it out to a blowfish? I mean, not really, but I don't have any evolutions to be getting something better next turn, so I guess we're committing. That's the stinky part about getting a tier 3, you know? Is that you feel like you probably should be using it because it's better than what you got. But at the same time, you gotta realize that tier 3s almost always really suck. So you're like, I should use this. It's better than what I have, but also it sucks and I really want something more, so I'm gonna skip it. And in this whole thought process, you've basically lost a bunch of time and a bunch of scaling because you couldn't commit. Now, do I want that guy to get it? I guess. Yeah, whatever. Joke's on you. We're actually gonna scale this raccoon. I can't be saying that it's really what destroyed me last time if I'm not willing to put up with it this time. Another scaler? Another level 2 flamingo straight into the raccoon buffs? That could be amazing. Feels a little sad. He's got the same amount of stats as the raccoon, so it's kind of like killing his own twin, but... Okay, Ox. Alright. That could have been your time to shine, raccoon. Sadly, you were not correct in order. I'll take the blame. That was my blame. You may lay the blame on me, tell your friends that your mom said no, and that wasn't your fault. Even if it's really you who didn't want to go. Okay, I sold that because I was immediately like, ooh, orangutan, let's just buy that. I hate this man. His ability, right, plus 4 health, that's amazing. Never do I have a team in which the person with the least amount of health is someone I care to be getting it, though. And so I guess you could think, well, isn't that fine? Is it fine that someone who you don't care about is getting it, actually? Because even if it's like a crocodile, you know? A crocodile's most thing is being a sniper, not necessarily having great stats, so maybe it's actually fine. Because he's gonna stick around to give him stats anyway. Maybe in the late game orangutan's good, but in the early game I'm switching so hot. I'm switching things every turn that it's like the chances that I have a small thing that wants it so low. Okay, so who wants it this time? You're actually a lot cooler. And this is going to be an expensive turn, because I want to level you. A shark? It's better than my other options, although we are absolutely not running. No! Oh yes, okay. My brain was flashing back to last game. I thought that was a level 2 giraffe, and then I was like, no, I've wasted an entire free apple's worth. How am I ever going to financially recover from this? I won't. Okay, strong hippo, you got me there. In terms of getting me there, a strong hippo sure did get me. 2 wins and 1? Dang, I feel like I don't know how disappointing it is. Are videos still fun when I lose constantly? I mean, it's still fun for me, but I guess I have some other people to be thinking about at that point. What do you do? Give 1 random friend from the current shop tier, plus 1, plus 2. A tier 4? Joke's on me, I don't have one of those, but I could see how that could be cool. I would like to put a garlic on him. Temporarily. It's a temporary garlic. If only because, especially in the early game, like I've said so many times before, raccoon is stinky in the early game, and it often doesn't actually steal anything, so a garlic at least will let do something? Nope, nope, and nope. Alrighty then. Extremely sad. A lot of sadness going on. I hope nobody's crying. I forgot to bring tissues. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.